that has opened our Bible to the book of Psalms 54 and 55. Psalm 54 and 55. Trust of the betrayed. Trust of the betrayed. Psalm 55. Psalm 55, verses 1 to 3. David complains of the malice of his enemies. The superscription mentions the Ziphim, who were the inhabitants of the wilderness, south of Hebron. David had hidden from Saul in the desert, but the Ziphim operated as Saul's spies, monitoring David's movements and reporting back to the king in 1 Samuel 23, verses 15 to 25. However, such specifics aren't included in the Psalms. Yahweh is faithful, though men are not to be trusted, and it is well for us, it is so. David has no other plea to depend upon than God's name, no other power to depend upon than God's strength. And these he makes his refuge and confidence. This would be the effectual answer to his prayers. Looking unto David, betrayed by the men of Judah, and to Yahshua, betrayed by one of his apostles, what can we expect from any who have not set Yahweh before them, save ingratitude, treachery, malice, and cruelty? What bonds of nature, or friendship, or gratitude, or covenant will hold those who have broken through the fear of God? Selah, which is mark this. Let us set Yahweh before us at all times, for if we do not, we are in danger of despair. Psalm 54 verses 4 to 7, assurance of the divine favor and protection. David voices his complaint, ruthless, ungodly, aggressive men are trying to kill him. The Ziphim are little more than informants, but by the time of David's encounter with them, he had been on the run from Saul for a long time. During those years, he had undergone some periods of great faith and some other trying times, but Yahweh had sustained him through them all. Behold, Yahweh is my helper. If we are for him, he is for us. And if he is for us, we need no fear. We need not fear. Every creature is that to us and no more, which Yahweh makes it to be. Yahweh will in due time save his people, and in the meantime, he sustains them and bears them up, so that the spirit he has made shall not fail. There is truth in Yahweh's warning, as well as in his promises. Sinners who do not repent will find it so to their cost. David's present deliverance was an earnest of further deliverance. He speaks of the completion of his deliverance. as a thing done. So he had as yet many troubles before him, because having Yahweh's promise for it, he was sure of it as if it was done already. Yahweh would deliver him out of all his troubles. May Father Yahweh help us to bear our cross without repining, and at length bring us to share his victories and glory. Christ followers never should suffer the voice of praise and thanksgiving to cease in the church of the redeemed. Psalm 55. Psalm 55 verses 1 to 8. Prayer to Yahweh to manifest his favor. Verses 1 to 5. The introduction does not provide specifics about the event that inspired these psalm, but the psalm itself reveals a painful betrayal by someone who had been a close friend. The psalm may have been inspired by Absalom's revolt, during which several of David's trusted associates deserted him. One of note is Ahithophel in 2 Samuel 15 verse 12, grandfather of his wife Bathsheba, perhaps the wisest advisor in the nation, who, after Absalom fails to take his advice, realizes David will regain the throne, and he commits suicide in 2 Samuel 16 verse 20 to 2 Samuel 17 verses 13 and 23. However, no proof exists of this possibility, and commentators are left to speculate. David's appeal to Yahweh includes an account of both treatment he is receiving from others and the inner turmoil it is creating in him. He describes a progression from anguish to fear and trembling to horror. In these verses we have, first, David praying. Prayer is a salve for every sore and a relief to the spirit under every burden. Second, David weeps, grieves in some measure, while those increase to that have no vent given them are thus lessened. Third, David in great alarm. We may well suppose him to be so upon the breaking out of Absalom's conspiracy and the falling away of the people. Horror overwhelmed him, probably the remembrance of his sin in the matter of Uriah added much to the terror. When under a guilty conscience, we must mourn in our complaint, and even strong believers have for a time been filled with horror. But none ever was so overwhelmed as the holy Yahshua, when it pleased Yahweh to put him to grief and to make his body an offering for our sins. In his agony, Yahshua prayed more earnestly and was heard and delivered. Trusting in him and following him, we shall be supported under and carried through all trials. See how David was weary of the treachery and the ingratitude of men, and the cares of and disappointment, the cares and disappointment of his high position, he longed to hide himself in some desert from the fury and fickleness of his people. He did not aim at victory, but rest a barren wilderness so that he might be quiet. The wisest and best of men most earnestly covet peace and quietness, and the more when vexed and wearied with noise and glamour and clamor. This makes death desirable to a child of God, that it is a final escape from all the storms and tempests of this world to perfect and everlasting rest. Psalm 55 verses 9 to 15. The great wickedness and treachery of his enemies. No wickedness so distresses the believer as that which he witnesses in those who profess to be of the Church of God. Let us not be surprised at the corruption and disorders of the Church on earth, but long to see the New Jerusalem. He complains of one that had been very industrious against him. Yahweh often destroys the enemies of the church by dividing them, and an interest divided against itself cannot long stand. The true Christ follower must expect trials from professed friends, from those with whom he has been united. This will be very painful, but by looking into Yahshua, we shall be enabled to bear it. Christ was betrayed by a companion, a disciple, an apostle, who resembled Ahithophel in his crimes and doom. Both were speedily overtaken by divine vengeance. And this prayer is a prophecy of the everlasting ruin of all who oppose and rebel against the Messiah. Psalm 55 verses 16 to 23. David is sure that God would in due time appear for him. Verses 16 to 17. In the wake of such emotional trauma, David cries out to Yahweh, evening, morning, and midday. David's regular prayer times are reminiscent of Daniel's faithfulness and commitment to pray three times a day in Daniel 6 verse 10. We might say morning, noon, and night, but David says evening and morning and noon, because the Jewish day started at sundown. In every trial, let us call upon Yahweh, and he will save us. He shall hear us and not blame us for coming too often. The oftener, the more welcome. David had thought all were against him, but now he sees there were many with him, more than he supposed, and the glory of this he gives to Yahweh. for it is he that raises up, he raises us up, friends, and makes them faithful to us. There are more true Christ followers and believers have more real friends than in their gloomy hours they suppose. His enemies should be reckoned with and brought down. They could not ease themselves of their fears as David could by faith in Yahweh. Mortal men, so ever so high and strong, will easily be crushed by an eternal God. Those who are not reclaimed by the rod of affliction will certainly be brought down to the pit of destruction. The burden of affliction is very, very heavy, especially when attended with the temptations of Satan. There is also the burden of sin and corruption. The only relief under it is to look to Christ, who bore it. Whatever it is that you desire, Yahweh should give you. Leave it to him to give it in his own way and time. Care is a burden. It makes the heart stoop. We must commit our ways and works to Yahweh. Let him do as it seems good to him. And let us be satisfied. To cast our burden upon Yahweh is to rest upon his providence and promise. And if we do so, he will carry us in the arms of his power, as a nurse carries a child, and will strengthen our spirits by his Spirit, his Holy Spirit, so that they shall sustain the trial. Yahweh will never suffer the righteous to be moved, to be so shaken by any troubles as to quit their duty to Yahweh or their comfort in him. He will not suffer them to be utterly cast down. He who bore the burden of our sorrows desires us to leave to him, to bear the burden of our cares, that as he knows what is best for us, he may provide it accordingly. Why do not we trust Christ to govern the world which he redeemed? Know this, and the Lord Yahweh will bless you. Amen. Let us take these prayer points. Save me, Lord Yahweh, by your name. Vindicate me by your might. In the name of Yeshua, save me, Lord Yahweh, by your name. Vindicate me by your might. In the name of Yeshua, save me, Lord Yahweh, by your name. Vindicate me by your might. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, we pray. Hear my prayer, O God. Listen to the words of my mouth. In the name of Yeshua, hear my prayers, O Father Yahweh. Listen to the words of my mouth. In the name of Yeshua, hear my prayer, O God. Listen to the words of my mouth. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, we pray. Arrogant foes are attacking me. Ruthless people without regard for Yahweh are trying to kill me. Surely Yahweh is my help. The Lord is the one who sustains me. In the name of Yeshua, let evil recoil on those who slander me. Yahweh Shaphat, in your faithfulness, destroy them. In the name of Yeshua, let evil recoil on those who slander me. Yahweh Shaphat, in your faithfulness, destroy them. In the name of Yeshua, let evil recoil on those who slander me. Yahweh Shaphat, in your faithfulness, destroy them. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, we pray. I will sacrifice a free will offering to you, Lord Yahweh. I will praise your name, for it is good. In the name of Yeshua, I will sacrifice a free will offering to you, Lord Yahweh. I will praise your name, for it is good. In the name of Yeshua, I will sacrifice a free will offering to you, Lord Yahweh. I will praise your name, for it is good. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, we pray. Father Yahweh, you have delivered me from all my troubles, and my eyes have looked in triumph on my foes. In the name of Yeshua, Father Yahweh, you have delivered me from all my troubles, and my eyes have looked in triumph on my foes. In the name of Yeshua, Father Yahweh, you have delivered me from all my troubles, and my eyes have looked in triumph on my foes. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, we pray. Listen to my prayer, my Father, my God. Do not ignore my plea. Hear me and answer me. In the name of Yeshua, listen to my prayer, my Father, my God. Do not ignore my plea. Hear me and answer me. In the name of Yeshua, listen to my prayer, my Father, my God, Yahweh. Do not ignore my plea. Hear me and answer me. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, we pray. My thoughts trouble me, and I am distraught because of what my enemy is saying, because of the threats of the wicked. For they bring down suffering on me, and assail me in their anger. My heart is in anguish within me. The terrors of death have fallen on me. Fear and trembling have beset me. Horror has overwhelmed me. I wish I had the wings of a dove. I would fly away and be at rest. I would flee far away and stay in the desert. I would hurry to my place of shelter, far from the tempest and storm. Lord Yahweh, confuse the wicked, confound their words, for I see violence and strife in the city. In the name of Yeshua, Lord Yahweh, confuse the wicked, confound their words, for I see violence and strife in the city. In the name of Yeshua, Lord Yahweh, confuse the wicked, confound their words, for I see violence and strife in the city. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, we pray. Destructive forces are at work in the city. Threats and lies never leave its streets. If an enemy were insulting me, I could endure it. If a foe were rising against me, I could hide. But insulting me is you, a man like myself, my companion, my close friends, with whom I once enjoyed sweet fellowship at the house of Yahweh, as we walked about among the worshippers. Yahweh Shaddai, let death take my enemies by surprise. Let them go down alive to the realm of the dead, for evil finds a lodging among them. In the name of Yeshua, Yahweh Shaddai, let death take my enemies by surprise. Let them go down alive to the realm of the dead, for evil finds lodging among them. In the name of Yeshua, Yahweh Shaphat, let death take my enemies by surprise. Let them go down alive in the realm of the dead, for evil finds lodging among them. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, Messiah, we pray. As for me, I call to Yahweh. I call to God and Yahweh saves me. In the name of Yeshua, as for me, I call to God and Yahweh saves me. In the name of Yeshua, as for me, I call to God and Yahweh saves me. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, Messiah, we pray. Evening, morning, and noon, I cry out in distress, and he hears my voice. In the name of Yeshua, evening, morning, and noon, I cry out in distress, and Yahweh hears my voice. In the name of Yeshua, evening, morning, and noon, I cry out in distress, and he hears my voice. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, Messiah, we pray. Yahweh Ezer, excuse me, unharmed from the battle waged against me, even though many oppose me. In the name of Yeshua, Yahweh Ezer, excuse me, unharmed from the battle waged against me, even though many oppose me. In the name of Yeshua, Yahweh Ezer, excuse me, unharmed from the battle waged against me. Even